Hello, my name is Frédéric Marie. I cycle Africa. I began in Johannesburg 3 months ago. From Johannesburg, I cycled to Mozambique, then Lesotho, and from Lesotho to Port Elizabeth. I cycled the coast to Cape Town, and from Cape Town, I cycled to Namibia, along the coast, the western coast of South Africa. We are now in Botswana, and tomorrow I will cycle to Zambia. And after Zambia, I will cycle to Malawi, then Tanzania. I will climb the Kilimanjaro, not with a bicycle for sure. I will go to Zanzibar. After Zanzibar, I will go again on the eastern part of Africa. I will go to Rwanda, Burundi, and Uganda to see gorillas. And from then, I will go back to Kenya. I will cross the northwest of Kenya and go to Ethiopia. And I will probably stop in Djibouti. In 10 months, I think I will cycle 18,000 kilometers. Until now, I cycle 4,500 kilometers. My bicycle is just here. And now we can have a look to the equipment. So the bicycle is made with aluminium. It's a very light bicycle, but it's also a very strong bicycle. The bike with all the luggage is around 50 kilos. And of course, I have everything to leave for 1 year on my own. So I have, for example, a filter, because I need water a lot, and in many places, water is not good to drink, so I can filter and I can drink water from the river. We are very close to the Zambezi River, and it's possible for me to drink the water from the river. I have a stove, and for the stove to cook, I use gasoline, unleaded fuel, and because it's very easy to find everywhere in Africa. A tank, because for example in Namibia the distances were very big, and I needed to cycle sometimes 300 kilometers. It means 2 days, sometimes with no water. So I have a 5 liter tank, more 3 bottles. My stove, it's a very small stove, which works with the gasoline. Small GPS, just to check my position, because in fact every day I use a map, and I prefer to use a map because if I have a GPS, it means that I have to charge it, and it's not easy sometimes to find a place to charge the batteries. I have special tires. They are supposed to last 15,000 kilometers with no punctures. But in 4,500 kilometers, I had maybe 10 punctures because the bike is very heavy and the road was very bad. The wheels are special also, with 36 spokes. Because of all the luggages, the wheels have to be very strong. To speak about my equipment, about my clothes, I don't have a lot because clothes are very heavy. So I have only 2 t-shirts, 2 sweatshirts, few pair of shorts, cycling shorts, and 2 pairs of shoes, cycling shoes and normal shoes. And in fact, that's it, because I don't need more. And I try to wash my clothes maybe every week. I try to when water is not a problem, because for example, in Namibia, water was a problem, so I didn't wash a lot. But when you travel alone, it's not a big problem, because if you are dirty, you can stay dirty for a long time. It's not a problem. My legs have 2 colors. Because of the sun, I was badly burned in the first 3 weeks. Now it's okay. Photographic equipment, because I'm a photographer too. A front bag with few cameras. You saw the GoPro. I have a small compact camera. Very simple one, but it's very good, because in some places you can't use a reflex because it's not very safe, so I have this one. Very simple, but quite good camera. And I have a reflex like this with a protection because of dust. So it's a very simple 600D because it's quite compact and I can put it in my bag. And I have a zoom, quite a big zoom. What is interesting, it's quite light. And I can use only one lens every condition. But I'm a photographer, so I have also two other lenses. So I have a fixed lens, very simple fixed lens, Canon fixed lens, very, very bright, very interesting to make portraits. And I have a wide angle, very interesting when you are inside with no space. So it's a 10-24 and it's enough, it's not too heavy. I have only maybe 2 kilos of equipment, and it's very important also not to have such a big equipment. Instant noodles, because it's very light and it's full of carbohydrates, tomatoes, cheese, when I can find cheese, and bread. And the bread is quite good in Botswana, so I am French, bread is very important for me. Tea and coffee and sauce and salt and spice. I try to eat proper food, because for sure it's very important to eat good food when you cycle, because you need energy, a lot of energy. I have sugar, quite a lot. I never eat sugar when I am in France, but when I cycle, I need to eat a lot because I need energy. I have dry milk to put with the cereals. Today I have tomatoes because it was possible to buy tomatoes, but in other days it's other vegetables. I don't eat red meat because when I eat red meat, I have cramps the day after, so I avoid to eat red meat for sure. And I eat only fish and white meat. This is my tent. I sleep every night, almost every night in the tent. I met many people along the road. I travel alone, so it's quite easy to meet people. And I stayed in many places. Last night, for example, I stayed with a family very easily. I just asked, and 5 minutes after, I was in the garden with the family around. They make a fire, and it was very good. Here in Botswana, people are very friendly, so it's quite easy to ask the people and stay. I stayed, for example, a few days ago in a shop because it was quite cold. Before, in Namibia, it was not that easy because Namibia is a big country and there is nobody, in fact, only 2 million of people in such a big country. So I camp a lot in the wild, in the bush. I met people, but not a lot in Namibia because the country is very big and it's a kind of big desert. If I have to speak about South Africa was not so good because people was quite afraid of me. It's a bit strange to me, but when I was cycling in the middle of the country, the people stay very far from the fence when I ask to camp, and they were afraid of me. And I saw that the apartheid is not finished in many places, and the black people were afraid of white people, the white people were afraid of black people. And for me it was not very easy to live in these conditions for 3 weeks. And I also carry a laptop because I'm a photographer and graphic designer, and I try to make movies like this one in Namibia with many seals. So to finish, if you want to follow my trip, go on Facebook and search for Africa Cycle in one word and you will find me. I put many pictures and few texts, few words about my trip in French and in English. Thank you.